It's called international Fisher effect. By the way, the term Fisher effect should sound familiar because we already saw it in chapter 7. And actually this formula that we are now looking at should not look like anything new if you remember the Fisher effect from chapter 7. So the international Fisher effect says the risk-free rate in the USA minus the inflation rate in the USA equals the risk-free rate in some foreign country minus the inflation rate in that foreign country. The risk-free rate in the USA is also something that we call the nominal risk-free rate in the United States. And when we subtract the inflation rate, we get the so-called real interest rate in the USA. Same for the foreign country. The capital R subscript FC, that's the nominal risk-free rate in the foreign country. And when we subtract the foreign inflation rate from it, we get the real risk-free interest rate in the foreign country. So what does the international Fisher effect formula imply? What does it say? It says that the real interest rate in the USA equals the real interest rate in some foreign country, right? So international Fisher effect says that the real rate of return must be constant across countries. In other words, you know, what are real rates of returns? It's when you adjust your return on your money for inflation, like how much of your return the inflation takes away. The fact that the prices get higher, right? That kind of, you know, eats away part of the return you got in nominal terms. What would happen if the real interest rates were not equal across different countries? It would mean that investors would always have preference for like one country over other countries. Whichever country has a higher real rate of return on their money would be the only country they would move all their money into. But in order to have a balanced world of investments, we must have this international Fisher effect, holding true, right? So the fact that people, you know, investors kind of, you know, some invest here, some invest there, tell us that the international Fisher effect kind of genuinely holds. So if some countries have a really high interest rate that you can earn when you invest money there, it's probably because those countries also have very high increase in the cost of living over time, high inflation rate. And so everything kind of gets balanced out. High interest rate countries have, the reason actually they have high interest rates is because of the high inflation. But the difference between the nominal rate and inflation gives like the true wealth you earn on your money. And that true like real rate wealth that you earn on your money should be equal across all the different countries. So that's what the international Fisher effect says.